father. You may want to see them. This. Looks like that lever over there will free.
He will attack.
No, but I feel wrong to keep them in a cage like this.
Your emotions again, boy.
You can't hear their thoughts. I can.
Ignore them, and ready yourself.
Okay. Instead of rotting in a cage.
Your skill is improving. You fought well, Atreus.
Thank you, Father. Fresh air feels good. Yes, sir.
Boy, prepare yourself!
So, what happened to all the people who lived here?
Follow the clues, boy.
Right, right. Follow the clues. Okay, so there was an evil dwarf king, and he made all these people hunt monsters. The people put them in cages, and then I don't know.
We are missing a clue.
Back inside the castle?
No. There is nothing more for us inside. But stay alert for chain dragons, boy. Perhaps you'll uncover more about this dwarf king.
Well, here it is. It's gotta have a weak one. Doing this himself.
Fall this easily, boy.
I know. I was just joking.
Nor are they a joking matter.
Sorry. Father, why do the gods cause so much trouble for mortals?
Because that is their nature.
But with all that power, you would think at least some of them would try to make life better for people.
And yet, the gods continue to spread misery. This is life, boy.
Well, at least we're doing some good, right?
You scare up that alchemist, what needed finding? Sorry you wasted my time.
Huh?
engineer. What can you tell me about that giant lady with the bow?
She was called Skadi, Queen of the Hunt. Her father was Thjotsi, who could take the shape of any wild creature, and taught Skadi how to hunt them all. From the ribs of pack beasts, she fashioned second feet, allowing her to glide upon the... snow, so no animal could evade her. She became a huntress beyond compare, even to any god. Odin himself wanted her for his bride, believing she would bear him strong sons. But she spurned his affections, and for that insult, Odin vowed revenge. It was put forth that the Aesir were plagued by an eagle who would steal the precious golden apples of Idun. Not even the finest archer among the gods could bring it down. Odin knew that Skadi could not resist the temptation to prove herself superior. And we'll pick this up later.
The statue stands no longer, Spirit.
Then my bond to this realm is severed, and I am off to find the real God of Thunder. He will know retribution. My deepest gratitude.
Off he goes. Brave God. Want to look for Thor on his own.
He is a fool.
What if the Spirit leave us?
An offering to one of the gods.
Can we use it?
No. But perhaps the dwarves can.
Story before.
Was I? Oh yes! Seeking revenge on Skadi the Huntress, Odin spread rumors that Aesir were plagued by an eagle, and so she joined the hunt. Skadi tracked the eagle as it flew where she alone could glide, and loosed an arrow from her unerring bow. When she collected her quarry, she found no eagle at all, but her own father, poor Thjotsi, slain by his own daughter.
I'll just tell you the story later.
Collected the rest of your woman's corpse spirit. Show us this magic you have promised.
Ah, my sweet Gulvig. Whole again. Rise, dear Gulvig. Awaken, oh powerful Gulvig!
Evni ukar bithias.
She says she'll honor our request.
Eldi fagnar.
And reunite us?
In Gowther!
Okay, you were right. I told you so.
I told you so.
You are naive, foolish boy.
This is true as well. But do not take your disappointment out on me, boy.
That story you started?
We were near the end of Skadi's tale, as the Queen of the Hunt discovered that Odin had tricked her into slaying her own father. She was overcome with grief and shame, for there is nothing nature so reviles as a child who kills their parent. Skadi succumbed to her fate as winter's blanket fell, holding her father as the mountain held her in an embrace to last eternity.
Well, that was sad.
There aren't many happy endings for the giants, I'm afraid.
Focus up!
Part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you? Responsibility.
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to, but not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here, with you, makes me feel more grown up.
Almost. If we could just find the other pieces of the language disc. Seriously, how did this one captain lead so many men?
He had their loyalty, so they followed.
And then they all died. He must have been a bad leader.
Why do you think that?
Well, he led all these men. To their deaths.
True. These men chose to follow. Even good leaders make poor choices. The best take responsibility for them. Remember this. Yes. I led men in battle.
Were you a good leader?
It is complicated.
Did you
no
ever...
No more questions, boy. Focus on the task at hand.
Yes, sir.
Himself.
But he would have never been able to.
That does not matter to him. Our victory will only remind him of his failure.
Then, why do we do this? Father, why did you really want to help the spirit?
You need the experience.
I've had plenty of experience fighting these things. What's the real reason?
This man inspired loyalty. He took responsibility for his mistakes, and... was determined to fix them. These are good lessons for you.
Oh.
Yes. Oh.
That's right. We laid them all to rest.
I see. So even in death, I am a failure.
But in life you were honorable, strong-willed, and you inspired loyalty. These are good qualities. aren't they, boy?
Yeah. I couldn't believe how many men followed you here.
I thank you for your kind words. May your journey have a more pleasant end than mine.
Well, you're right. You didn't seem very satisfied. I guess you never really get over losing ones you care about.
Never.
I can't believe no one has found the Jotunheim Tower after so many years. Where would you hide something that big?
Come on. born.
This is the last one. Might as well, right?
Fine.
Focus up, boy.
Lake with a group of tradesmen seeking refuge from.
We cannot undo.
I know that.
Is there.
I.
Oh.
Wait!
Deal.
Thank you.
You are learning.
Why didn't you or Mom ever tell me about the desolation?
I won't speak for your mother, but it was never my concern, nor should it be yours.
Doesn't it concern us if everything around us is dying?
Our only concern is reaching Jotunheim.
Really? Then why are we exploring all these islands?
The resources we find improve our equipment. If we stray from the path, it is only to prepare ourselves for the journey ahead.
I can live with that if it means we keep exploring.
Come on.
On his beach.
Come, boy.
about this. Hey, Brock, take a look at this thing.
Freezing!
Huh?
Oh, never you mind. Tyr would have been pleased as peaches knowing these offerings were being turned to armor.
Did you know him? What was he like?
Never you mind, boy. Tyr's dead. Best not to dig up the past.
The dwarf speaks wisely, for once.
I need that alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If in your smarts, you'll find him. Check back soon.
Read it.
Yes, sir.
These runes read death inside.
You scare up that alchemist? What needed finding?
So, Brock said his friend was dwarven like him. Wearing a green ring.
Look if you wish. I will be gathering resources for our journey.
You don't want to help him?
No.
Why not?
Because I do not run errands for dwarves.
Dwarven, but no ring. One of his crew?
Scorch marks. There, along the floor and wall.
Weird. I guess we keep looking.
We?
I mean, I'll keep looking. Sound more dangerous than that.
Then do not drop your guard. Come. the lack of ring while looting the body.
Ah.
No ring. We're not gonna find Brock's friend alive, are we?
Boy, over here.
Another map! Great! severed hand?
Attached to the Soul Eater.
Well, we know what happened to Invari now. We can just go tell Brock. No need to fight it, right?
No. Fight it.
But why?
Because you are frightened of it. Done here. Be strong, Atreus. Stay focused and look for a weak point.
Yes, sir.